Hey guys, I will talk about another important topic in semiconductor packaging, which is the package structure. This will help to have a better understanding of semiconductor packaging and the corresponding assembly processes that I will discuss in detail in future videos. This is Lito Galera and welcome to my Watch, Learn and Play channel. Let's start with the common wire-bonded lidded packages. These are the ones that have the leads extending out on the sides like galloping. If you have seen before a printed circuit board populated with components, it is very likely that there's at least one component of this type. These packages are QFP, which has leads on all four sides, and also SOIC, SSOP, TSSOP type packages, which have leads on two sides. Let's say we cross-section the package, slicing the body of molding compound and through the die. What you will see in the cross section is the illustration on the right side of your screen. There are basically five main components in the cross section of a wire bonded package: die, wire, epoxy, the attach pad, leads, and molding compound. To understand the details of package construction, let's zoom in on the cross-section as shown on the right side of your screen. Very important requirement of any package is a package thickness. The package thickness is not just a random or preferred thickness by manufacturer. This is actually defined within the JEP95 JEDEC standard, which is a standard document for package outline in microelectronic industry. The standard package outline drawing details all the important dimensions that manufacturers follow. This is very important so that users can get devices from different manufacturers without worrying about footprint compatibility to their printed circuit board. To learn more about JEDEC standards, you can visit their website at www.jedec.org. If you register, you can actually access some free standards which are good for learning. Going back to our discussion, package thickness limits the height or vertical space the manufacturer can operate. Note that package thickness is different from package height. Package height is measured from the sitting plane height to the top of the package. This dimension is also defined in JEDEC standard. Lead frame thickness is also defined in the standard package outline drawing. Most manufacturers use the same lead frame thickness, especially if they are getting their lead frames from the same supplier. This is very cost efficient for both manufacturer and suppliers by saving on tooling costs. You will notice that the lead frame has downset. That is, the die attach pad is actually lower for galloping type packages. This gives more vertical space for the die and wire. The green color in the illustration is a die. Die thickness varies between manufacturers or even devices of the same manufacturer. In general, it is cheaper and easier to use thicker die. The thicker the die is, the less prone it is to breakage and easier to handle than thinner die. Raw wafers are thicker, roughly about 24 mils or 0.6 millimeter thick. For standard packages, the wafers are thinned to about 10 to 20 mils thick. Advanced packages requires much thinner die. Bandline thickness, or BLT, is the thickness of adhesive epoxy between the die and the die attach pad, typically at least 1 mil or 25 microns. Loop height of the wire is measured from the die surface to the top of the wire. You will notice that the wire is very close to the top of the package. In general, the wire-to-package clearance must be at least 2 mils or 50 microns. Otherwise, there's a risk of wire being exposed after laser marking the package. Let's talk about quad platinum lead package, or commonly known as QFN. QFN also uses copper lead frame. However, the leads are not protruding on the side of the package. Without the protruding leads, the QFN package is actually smaller than typical Galwing packages. This package is very popular for mobile devices or any electronic device that requires much smaller space. QFN lead frame has no downset. That is, the leads and the attach pad are of the same height. It is also a thinner package, typically around 1 mm thick, thus it requires a thinner die and lead frame and low loop height. A significant advantage of QFN package is the exposed pad, which helps improve the package thermal performance, particularly for discrete devices. Ball grid array or BGA is for high pin count applications, specifically for high pin count ICs. It uses laminated substrate made of layers of copper and prepreg. BGA has many different configurations. An example is a typical die-attach wire-bonded die configuration. For wire-bonded configuration, it requires thin die and low loop height. Another configuration is using flip chip die. It can also be a combination of wire bond and flip chip die in a multi-chip application. BGA terminals are array of solder balls and also various configurations depending on device requirement. I've shown basic structure of common packages, and there are many other packages of different structure, particularly in advanced packaging. However, I will not cover them yet in this video, so it won't be overwhelming. I'll be uploading more videos related to wafer saw, die attach, and wire bond with more process details. To support my videos and channels, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share my channel and this video. Thank you for watching.